Now, using your roof as a guide, figure out your horizon lines, your vanishing points, and diagonal vanishing points, or special vanishing points. Work out a grid for the sidewalk. This is also good for drawing things like doors and windows and keeping things to scale. Yeah, I guess I can do that. Just like that. Okay, this is going to be my official screen left vanishing point. I guess the other vanishing point will be maybe somewhere in here. So this is like the horizontal vanishing point. Okay, these are my vanishing point lines. So wherever I draw should follow these guys, these lines. Now, the grid. So that goes there, this goes here. I may have chosen the wrong color for this. So, special VP diagonal. It's just my opacity that's too low. Yeah, that seems to be a problem. Let's try that again. Diagonal. There we go. Nice. Special VP. Oh dear. Diagonal. Special VP. Diagonal. should make dinner. Decision 5. I should put on a different mask, so I should, but. Special VP. And I can't even see it anymore. Well, oh, there we go. Maybe my power is too low. Go as far as you can. This thickness of my lines, I can't really see this stuff anymore. Eventually get a grid kind of like this, and I should put that on separate layers. Oh, all right. So, the end result is it should look something like this. Now, use vanishing points to block in your major forms and use the grid to help keep windows and doors a consistent size. this goes over here. Okay, I'll just do that. Protector, this will be like doing this. They'll be doing this too. And then this guy will come out over here to like maybe here. And it looks good. Something like that. Just use as a guide, doesn't have to be 100%. It's a guide. It'd be nice, but this is easier. And put this guy up here. Maybe that'll be a building. Or maybe it'll be two buildings. I don't know. Maybe put like another dividing line over here. Okay. So the end will look something like this. Maybe, roughly, something like that. And, oh wait, let me put some more details in this. So, like I change it up. I'm just gonna like alter it slightly because there seems to be like a lot of tangents and like other anomalies that in the drawing that I'm going to attempt to accommodate for. My random dude over here instead. My random guy, I put him over here. So like, boom, I should put him somewhere else. He'd be like in front. He'd be in front. The guy can be in front and he'd be like leaning up against a lamppost or something. This dude can be like over here. You can't really see this, but I'm actually using my fingers to kind of like pinch the character and figure out the scale. Okay. So, something like that. And I did say I wanted to have like a kiosk in here. Somewhere, right? So, yeah, there's another tangent happening here. This isn't gonna fully get rid of it, but it'll be better. It'll be better than however it was before. Thank you. You have to be careful about making things too detailed, because if you make it too detailed, then it gets weird, because the human eye doesn't really see everything with the same depth, with the same amount of detail, or the brain, or the combination of the two. Somewhere between the two, they don't see things evenly, interpret things evenly like that. It looks kind of weird if you have too much detail in all levels. What you should do is like just choose a level and like make another, the other levels like either blurred or like less detailed or something like that. This will also like add variety to the image. It'll add depth, and the variety will make it like more interesting and attractive. You could go further if you want, but I think this is actually playing. It's playing for me, I think. I think I can like use this and carry on from.